CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 2.
Hello dear children, how are you all? I hope you all are doing great and you and your loved ones are safe at home. I know you all are missing your school, your friends, your teacher, your classroom, but believe me, in few weeks the school will reopen and you will be able to go back to your school. Once again, you will be able to attend your regular classes, but till then, I will help you in your studies at home in a fun-filled manner. Let me introduce myself. I am Shilpa. Today, we are going to have lots of fun. We will have fun while we learn. So, are you all ready for today's session? Wonderful! All right now, tell me one thing. Do you think that you are lucky? Well, I believe that I am lucky enough. And why do I think so? I am lucky because I can teach lovely children like you. Now, take few seconds and think about that. Why are you lucky? Yes, think about it. Think. Yes. Dear children, we all are lucky as God has gifted us a wonderful life to live. We all should thank God for our wonderful life. And you know what? This is the title of our today's poem, I Am Lucky. It is in Unit 2 of Marigold Book 2, your English textbook. If you have the book, open page number 20. If you don't, it doesn't matter. You can still hear the poem. Later, you can read it when you get the book. So don't worry at all. Let us now listen together to the poem titled, I Am Lucky. Here, in this poem, the child is feeling lucky just by being himself. Do you all want to know about this? I am sure you want to know. But before that, let's listen to this melodious poem together.
I am lucky.
If I were a butterfly, I would be thankful for my wings.
If I were a mynah in a tree, I would be thankful that I could sing.
If I were a fish in the sea, I would be thankful that I can wriggle and giggle with glee.
So I just think I'm lucky to be me. Not you, but me.
If I were an elephant, I would be thankful that I can raise my trunk.
If I were a kangaroo, I would try to hop right up to the moon.
If I were an octopus, I would be thankful for my 8 arms.
So I just think I'm lucky to be me. Not you, but me.
What do you think you want to be? Do you want to be like me? Or just you? Just you?
Hello lovely kids, I am back. Did you like the poem? Did you sing along? I am sure you must have enjoyed listening to the poem and you know the meaning of most of the words. But now, let us understand the meaning of some more new words and find out what the poet wants to say. So I will read the poem again, stanza wise. You also read the poem along with me. So the first stanza says, if I were a butterfly, I would be thankful for my wings. I'll again repeat. If I were a butterfly, I would be thankful for my wings. Dear children, the poet, who is a young girl, wishes to be a butterfly. If she were a butterfly, then she would have wings. If she had wings, then she would have been thankful for those wings. What can a butterfly do with its wings? It can fly. Have you ever seen a butterfly? Oh, I love watching butterflies flying in the garden. Have you ever noticed their wings? Are they of a single color or are they multicolored? The wings of the butterfly have different bright shades of red, blue, pink, purple, orange, and other colors too. They are beautiful. So now, let me read the second stanza for you. If I were a manna in a tree, I would be thankful that I could sing. I'll again repeat. If I were a manna in a tree, I would be thankful that I could sing. Next, the girl wishes to be a manna. She thinks that if she were a manna, she could sing. Since she could sing, so she would have been thankful for that blessing. Have you ever seen a manna? What does it do? Yes, tell me. Yes, it can also fly. But a manna also sings beautiful songs. Have you ever listened to the songs of manna? Oh, they are lovely and melodious. Do listen to the songs of the manna. Now, let me read the third stanza for you. If I were a fish in the sea, I would be thankful that I can wriggle and giggle with glee. Again, I'll repeat. If I were a fish in the sea, I would be thankful that I can wriggle and giggle with glee. Dear children, now the girl wishes to be a fish. What can a fish do? Yes, a fish can swim. It swims in the sea, river, or any other water body. What will happen to the fish if we take it out from water? The poor thing will die. Yes, it will die. Don't take a fish out of water, else it will die. Do you remember any rhyme on fish? Any nursery rhyme? Any poem or any song? I'm sure you know a poem or a song on fish in your mother tongue. Sing it with your friends when the school reopens. The fish loves to be in the water. Water is its life. It loves being in water. If the girl would be a fish, then she would be very happy because she could wriggle and giggle. Glee means being happy, and wriggle is the movement of the fish in the water. Have you seen how a fish swims in water? It takes twists and turns. And giggle means laughing lightly. The fish can move in water freely, and so it would be laughing as it is very happy. So the girl feels she would have been thankful if she were a fish. Let me read the next lines for you. So, I just think I am lucky to be me, not you, but me. So, I just think I am lucky to be me, not you, but me. The child says that she is lucky to be herself. Whatever she is, however she is lucky to be the individual that she is. She says that she is not like anybody else, but happy to be the way God has created her. We too should also be happy the way we are. Okay, children, so be happy the way you are. Let me read the next lines for you. If I were an elephant, I would be thankful that I can raise my trunk. If I were an elephant, I would be thankful that I can raise my trunk. So, dear children, next the girl wishes to be an elephant. Yes, an elephant. And what does she want? She says that if she had been an elephant, then she would have been thankful that she could raise her trunk. Yes, her trunk, high up in the air. What is a trunk? Do you know? Have you ever seen a trunk of an elephant? It's the long nose of the elephant. See, remember an elephant? You can see, visualize that the elephant has a long nose. Only elephants have long nose. You must have seen it. It is called trunk. An elephant uses its trunk to smell, breathe, drink, and to hold things. Now, enact like an elephant and raise your trunk and make it sound. Sound of elephant. Try to act like an elephant. Raise your trunk and make it sound. Like sound of the elephant, that is trumpet. Different animals and birds make different sounds. I will tell you some of the sounds. Like a cow, you know what sound a cow makes? It moos. What is the sound of a dog? A dog barks. A dog barks. And what is the sound of a tiger? A tiger roars. A tiger roars. What is the sound of a cat? A cat meows. Meow. A cat meows. And what is the sound of a horse? A horse neighs. A horse neighs. And what is the sound of a crow? A crow caws. A crow caws. You must have heard the sound of a crow. Caw, caw. So we say a crow caws. Let us move next to the next stanza. I will read the lines. You also read along with me. So the poet says, if I were a kangaroo, I would try to hop right up to the moon. If I were a kangaroo, I would try to hop right up to the moon. So dear children, next the poet wishes to be a kangaroo. Yes, a kangaroo. Do you know what a kangaroo is? You can see its picture on page 21 of the book. If you don't have the book, don't worry. I will tell you. A kangaroo is an animal which is found in Australia. It is a large animal with a very strong legs. The unique feature of the kangaroo is that it has a pouch. It carries its baby in its pouch. You can see there is a pocket in front of its stomach. It carries its baby in that pouch. How does a kangaroo move? A kangaroo actually hops. You know what is hopping? To hop means to jump. Have you seen a rabbit? A rabbit also hops. In a similar way, a kangaroo also hops. So the girl feels that if she would be a kangaroo, then she would be thankful that she can hop. She wishes to hop to reach the moon. Isn't the girl cute? She wants to reach the moon. So now, let me read the next few lines. If I were an octopus, I would be thankful for my 8 arms. If I were an octopus, I would be thankful for my 8 arms. So dear children, next the girl wishes to be an octopus. What is an octopus? Where do we find octopus? Can you think about octopus? Okay, I will tell you. An octopus is a sea animal, and you know what? It is very unique. I will tell you how. First, you tell me that how many arms do you have? Well, I have 2 arms, right arm and left arm. You all also have 2 arms. Raise your right arm up. Now put it down. Now raise your left arm up and put it down. Now try to hold your book with your both hands. Okay, have you done that? Try to hold your book with your both hands. Now raise your arms, raising the book too. Try to raise your arms and raise the book. Are you able to do that? Very good. Very good. Now put the book down and relax. 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 So we all have 2 arms and we use it for different purposes. But an octopus has 8 arms. Yes, you heard it correct. It has 8 arms. Isn't this amazing? What would you do if you had 8 arms? Just imagine. Try to imagine that if you have 8 arms, what will you do? Well, with my first arm, I would hold a sandwich. With the second arm, I would shake hands with a friend. With the third arm, I would write my homework. And let me think, what can I do with my fourth arm? Please help me think. I would do cleaning with the fifth arm. I would hold my eraser with my sixth arm. I would hold my paintbrush with the seventh arm. I would have juice, and with my last arm, I would comb my hair. So funny it is, isn't it? You also think about different things which you would do if you had 8 arms. The girl in the poem says that she would be thankful if she were an octopus, as she would have 8 arms. Now let me read the next few lines for you. So, I just think I'm lucky to be me, not you, but me. So dear children, again the girl says that she's lucky to be herself. Whatever she is, however she is, she feels lucky to be the individual she is. She says that she is not like anybody else, but happy to be the way God has created her. We should be happy the way we are. Try to be happy the way you are. So, the last lines, we have reached to the last lines. And listen carefully to these lines. What do you think you want to be? Do you want to be like me or just you? Just you. I'll again read the lines. What do you think you want to be? Do you want to be like me or just you? Just you. So, dear children, what do you want to be? Do you want to be like any other animal or do you like to be like me? In the end, the girl is asking you that do you want to be like her or do you want to be the way you are? The poet wants to tell us that we all should be happy the way God has made us. Sometimes we wish to be like others, but we should not think so. We should learn to love ourselves. We should believe that God has made us the best. That was real fun, wasn't it? Did you like the poem? I really liked the poem. Alright, now I shall be speaking some new words again and you all listen carefully and repeat after me. So, repeat the words after me. Butterfly. Butterfly. B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. Butterfly. Manna. Manna. M-Y. N-A, manna. Elephant. Elephant. E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T. Elephant. Trunk. Trunk. T-R-U-N-K. Trunk. Kangaroo. Kangaroo. K-A-N-G-A-R-O-O. Kangaroo. Octopus. Octopus. O-C-T-O-P-U-S. Octopus. Thankful. T-H-A-N-K-F-U-L. Thankful. Wriggle. Wriggle. W-R-I-G-G-L-E. Wriggle. W is silent here, so we are reading it as wriggle. Next is giggle. Giggle. G-I-G-G-L-E. Giggle. Glee. Glee. G-L-E-E. Glee. Now, I'm going to ask you few questions. So, be ready to answer. Good. So, tell me first question. I will name an animal and you have to tell its actions. For example, I will ask a butterfly. So you have to answer, can fly. you have to tell me its action. So it's like a butterfly can fly. So next one, be ready. Amana. Amana, tell its action. Yes, the answer is can sing. Amana can sing. Yes, it can fly also. That is also correct. Amana can sing and it can fly. Okay, the next one, an elephant. Tell its action. The answer is can raise its trunk. Elephant can walk also. An elephant can lift a log of wood also. See, elephant can do a lot of things. Now tell me, what action can you do? Like, if I have to tell you, I will say, I can dance. What can you do? So you can tell me whether you can sing, or you can paint, you can draw, you can dance, or you can play. So whatever you can do, you can tell me that. So what action can you do? Please tell me. So did you like this game? Let's play another fun activity. Now, I will tell you the action and you have to guess the animal. So tell me, so my question for you is, Dash can wriggle. So tell me, who can wriggle? Right. It's the fish that can wriggle, correct. Okay, now tell me, Dash can hop. Think about it. Who can hop? Correct. It's the kangaroo that can hop. Rabbit can also hop. Both are correct. Now, answer some of the questions. Why do you think the butterfly likes its wings? Yes, a butterfly likes its wings because they are colorful and they help it to fly. Okay, the next question. What can the mynna do? Tell me, what can the mynna do? Yes, the mynna can sing. It can fly in the sky. Correct. Okay, the next question. Do you think the fish was really happy to be in the water? Do you think the fish was really happy to be in the water? Yes, the fish was happy in the water as it was giggling and it could swim in water. She was enjoying that. So my next question is, what are the lucky things that have happened to you? Think about the lucky things that have happened to you. Like, I will tell you, I feel lucky to have a beautiful and happy family. I feel that I am lucky to have a beautiful and happy family. You also think about the lucky things that have happened to you. Think about them. Now, let's play a silent game. I know you are thinking, play a game? A silent game? How? Isn't the name wonderful? Yes, it is. Do one thing, close your eyes and listen to the words which I would be saying. Imagine pictures, whatever comes to your mind as you listen. So, the first one is butterfly. Imagine that you are seeing a butterfly. Is it colorful? Is it flying? How lovely! Don't open your eyes. Keep your eyes closed. Now, imagine a mynna. It is flying high up. Now it is coming down to you. No cheating. Don't open your eyes. Now, imagine a fish. Try to see it in your imagination. Okay, try to imagine the fish swimming in the water. Next, imagine an elephant. I hope you have not opened your eyes. Imagine an elephant. The last one is a kangaroo. Imagine it too. A large animal with strong legs, nice bright eyes, and a stomach with a pocket in it. Now, slowly open your eyes and take a deep breath and do what I ask you to do. You had imagined a butterfly. Now move like a butterfly. Open your wings and fly. Fly, fly, fly. Open your wings and fly. Done. Now move like a manna. Again fly. Fly, fly high, high and high. Keep flying. Very nice. Now swim like a fish. Swim, swim and swim in the sea. Keep swimming. Swim, swim, swim. Okay, stop, stop, stop. Now let's move like an elephant. Raise your trunk high. Raise your trunk high. Higher, higher. Very nice. I hope you are enjoying. Now hop like an kangaroo. Hop 3 times. Hop, hop and hop. Oh, I hope you have hopped 3 times. If not, again hop. Hop, hop and hop. Well done. I hope you had fun. Now listen to these words. Hop, roar, swim and fly. I'll repeat. Hop, roar, swim and fly. I would be speaking some incomplete sentences. You have to complete the sentences using these words. So the words are hop, roar, swim and fly. So the first sentence is, if I were a kangaroo, I would dash. So which word will complete the sentence? Yes, hop. If I were a kangaroo, I would hop. So now the second sentence. If I were a tiger, I would dash. Try to fill the sentence with the word. Which word will complete the sentence? Yes, roar. If I were a tiger, I would roar. Remember, I told you tiger roars. If I were a fish, I would dash. Now try to complete the sentence. Which word will complete the sentence? Yes, swim. If I were a fish, I would swim. Okay, next. If I were a bird, I would dash. So, which word will complete the sentence? Yes, fly. If I were a bird, I would fly. Birds fly in the sky. It was great talking to you children. I hope you got the meaning of the poem, I Am Lucky, that we all are good, we all should love ourselves and we can do a lot of things. So dear kids, I hope you all enjoyed this session and I am giving you a small activity which you can do easily at your house. You have to write 5 things that you can do. Start your sentence with I can. Like, I will tell you. I will say, I can read. So write 5 things that you can do. You also have to write 5 things that you cannot do. Start your sentence with I cannot. Like, I will tell you. I'll say, I cannot fly. I know you all will be able to write these sentences. Now, dear children, it's time to say goodbye. I will soon come again with another beautiful audio for you all lovely children. Till then, take care, stay safe and be happy.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.